welcome one and all. First, we would like to recognize the presence of the family and friends of the graduates, the school administration, the district administration, and the Board of Education, for without them, school would have no meaning. Tonight, we are assembled for the moment that all high school seniors have been yearning for. Yes, it's the commencement exercises of the eminent, distinguished, remarkable, extraordinary, noble, mighty, supreme, noteworthy, esteemed, renowned, illustrious, grand, sublime class of 1985. We will now let the Bonneville High School graduate ceremony begin.
The audience, please arise. Now you repeat the Pledge of Allegiance with me.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may please be seated.
The opportunity we have to join together today as graduates and family and friends. This time we'd like to thank those who have made us able to graduate. And we're thankful for the United States that we live in, that we have a free education system, and that we're thankful for the educators and for the faculty and all the administration, and we're thankful for the parents we have that have pushed us through high school and have helped us and aided us and gone through it with us. And we're thankful for the peers that we have that this night they might be wise and no one would be hurt. And we hope that you'll help us and make sure no harm befalls anybody. We would ask you to be with the speakers and those that will be on the rest of the program today, that they might be at ease, that they might get across the points that they wish to. And we say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Next on our program will be our student speakers. In order to be chosen for this, they had to try out before a committee. First of all, it will be Jennifer Latham, our senior representative. She'll be followed by Greg Weber, who's our student body president, followed by Stacy Crowe, who is forensics president and National Honor Society secretary. She'll be followed by Brett Blake, who has served this year as seminary president. And finally, will be Greg Thorpe, our senior president, with his remarks. Bahen, Deran Fang, Empezios Nuevos, Commencement, Beginnings. No matter what language we speak, nor what country we come from, we are all faced with new beginnings. Overnight, we can shift from being a pro to a beginner. All of us have experienced this starting over cycle in school. We struggle through those elementary school grades, those unforgettable years of reading, writing, and arithmetic. We are the biggest, the toughest, and the greatest that ever walked the halls of that school. This high and mighty feeling did not last long enough, however, as the days of hopscotch, marbles, show and tell were over, and we were greens again starting at junior high. Junior high was a frightening experience. Not only did we have seven new teachers to face, but every time we got the combination on our locker mastered, a ninth grader would come up behind it and slam it shut. This was a rough time in junior high. We finally made it through eighth grade, and then we became awesome ninth graders. This is when we could slam a locker door shut on seventh graders. It was great to be the pro, not the beginner. Overnight, it seemed like we were worried about being anchored. We tried to hide every time we saw Bonneville anchor coming our way. This is a rough summer mustering up the courage to enter the halls of Great Bonneville High School. At Bonneville, we developed new and lasting friendships that widened in passing times. The new challenges came fast and furious, and some were even overwhelming. However, all these experiences have helped us grow and mature. The classes we have taken have widened our horizons. The relationships that were formed with teachers and students will have lasting influences in our lives. Each year at Bonneville has been outstanding, giving us memories that we can look back on. Although our senior year has surpassed them all, that the joy of accomplishment has never been greater. We have proven to everyone that Lakers are truly great. Being number one in athletics as well as academics and music, this is the year of the Lakers. As we graduate tonight, we find ourselves in another new beginning. What would happen if we didn't have these starting over points? As people work up to the top in almost any endeavor, they develop a system of labels. Who is the smartest, the fastest, the most unorganized, or the biggest airhead? If life never started over, what would happen if in sixth grade we got dubbed the biggest gomer or the biggest airhead, and then we never got a chance to start over again? These starting over cycles make possible the opportunity for improvement and advancement. Some of us are fearful, however, of these changes and would rather stick with familiar surroundings rather than venturing out into new beginnings. Lakers, let me challenge you to use this new beginning as a stepping stone towards setting new goals and reaching new heights. Remember, the man on top of the mountain didn't just fall there. Our new beginnings are not over. We will have many yet to come. College will be a new beginning for some, marriage for others, while jobs and careers will create a new beginning for almost all of us. At times it may seem unfair that we just get to the top of a certain endeavor and then we have to start at the bottom again. But it's this cycle that keeps us on some path of growth and progression. How non-developmental for any of us to have it made in life, to never have to stretch forth his mind and his talents and then to begin again. Wonderful it is for most of us to be able to get out of the old rut, to be able to sprout new wings, soar into new heights, and even then to begin again. The tide recedes, but leaves bright seashells upon the sand. The sun goes down, but gentle warmth lingers upon the land. The music stops, yet it echoes on in sweet refrains. For every joy that passes, something beautiful remains. Lakers, this is it. Let's make it great. Thanks.
Mr. Francis, Mr. DeYoung, parents, visitors, and to the mighty graduating class of 1985. It was just 12 short years ago that we began our sojourn in public education. We were all at one time awed by the seeming complexity of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, not to mention reading and writing. But these times have obviously passed very quickly, and we now find ourselves moving out into the real world. Let us not, however, make this transition without ever holding fast to that which we have pursued and to that in which we have excelled. We are definitely an excellent class, and we have made numerous accomplishments in every field, academics, athletics, and music, just a few. We set a new mark for the most scholarship money ever brought in by a class in the school's history. And not only did we break the old mark, but we almost more than doubled it, and the present record stands at $560,000. At Utah State University, the Bonneville team, led by seniors, brought home the Star Wars trophy for the academic Olympiad portion of the competition. There have been numerous Blue Bees awarded us for our persistence and for our dedication in attaining good grades. Athletically, we had in our senior year two state championship teams, one in boys basketball and one in girls soccer, which is not, as of now, a recognized high school sport. Our boys soccer team finished a high second in the state, and we capped off the year with six region championships. All of our teams did well. Individually, our own Chad Law broke the state record in the shot put event, and Brett Williams placed second in the state meet in the 3,200-meter run. Gina Butters was an All-American in basketball, and Mike Watson led the boys' basketball team as the MVP for the 4A basketball tournament. Musically, the Lakers had another banner year. In jazz band, we placed third in the state. We took a first in jazz and a first in symphonic band in the California Invitational Competition. The choir also competed in many festivals and competitions, and they performed very well. Our own Lakettes placed second in the region and went on to place fourth in the entire state. We have made other minor accomplishments, such as placing first in homecoming for 2 years in a row. And who can forget when the sophomores, our senior boys, beat the seniors in our sophomore boys beat the seniors in a tug of war. That was incredible. Although we have accomplished much in these fields of talent and competition, perhaps the most important accomplishment we have made is that of friendships. Although high school competitions may end, our friendships will go on forever. Yes, we have helped each other make it through these past few years, and the experiences we have had along the way will always be engraved in our hearts and in our minds. While we have helped ourselves pass this test, however, let us not forget parents, teachers, and administrators who have given us a solid foundation to build on. They have truly been the catalyst in preparing us for life after high school. Finished, yet just begun. Although our high school days are over, we may now enter the world with confidence because we have paid the price for success. We know the formula. We just have to decide what we want and then go after it with every ambition and every motivation that we can proceed. We must not be afraid to explore uncharted waters. The problem with most people today is not that they want too much, but that they settle for too little. As a graduating class of Bonneville High School, the world is at our feet. May we strive to succeed by exploring uncharted waters. May we have the will to go the distance and share with others that which we have gained in the past 12 years. And remember, once a Laker, always a Laker.